What's up, YouTube? So we're back with a new video now. By the title, you can already tell. But before we start, hit the like button, subscribe, and let's begin with my video. So everyone was saying Ida on live, and everyone was just confused on who she was talking about. But then comes to realize that, you know, she was sending all the message to Eli. And she says she doesn't care anymore being friends with Eli. But everything is about Eli ruining his surprise from Ida. It's a whole bunch. Just the way I'm confused. It's just the way everyone was confused on that live. But if you know what's going on, what's tea, leave your thoughts down below. Let me know what you guys think. And let me catch you within or at the end of the video.
You came into this world with a penis and balls. And at a certain age, your balls drop. So at a certain age, you should have became a man. Why are you not a man? Like, why are you like, everything's internet. And then y'all, well, oh, you're taking it too far. You're being disrespectful now. You're disrespectful. The moment I said, I don't like internet, you went on the internet. You disrespected me. You making it worse. It's over and done with. I said what I said. Once you go on the internet, you do what the you did. I don't give a I don't care. I don't give a I don't give a flying. No one can convince me otherwise. He can go cry about it. I don't give a sorry. Sorry, don't give a don't. Janae said get off. Well, she and Calvin should have warned his ass. Oh wait, they did. They did warn his ass. They told him not to go on live. And guess what he did? He went on live. How you get a warning? But when it's my turn, everybody needs to, oh Ida, stop, you're taking it too far. Y'all keep poking the bear. Leave me the fuck alone. If I'm mad, let me be mad in peace. You gonna go on the internet. Yeah, guys, she's mad at me. She's not right next to me. Da da da. Shut up. Suck my dick. Suck 30. How about that? Like, come on now. Like, if y'all don't be telling that nigga stop, if y'all don't be blocking him and banning him and this, that, and the third, leave me the fuck alone. No, now I'm gonna talk. I'm gonna keep going. Now, actually, now he just started something. I'm gonna keep going. Fuck you. Now, actually, to be honest, what? I told you not to get on the internet. You gonna get on the internet. You're an internet. So, you're a female. You were supposed to be a female. Like, you're a narcissist. Like, I'm gonna keep it going. I don't give a fuck no more. I don't care. I don't. Y'all talking about this skit? It's not a prank. Y'all favors, and I'm not. I'm a female, so
shit.
It is what it is. I hate that. I hate that for him. I really do. I'm a pray the out of him one day. Well, no, like he just needs. No, the change is really deep in a person. If that motherfucker's still moving how they fucking move and talking how they lock, out of here. I blame all y'all friends and them yes ass mans. Y'all some yes ass men, and all the niggas be knowing what's wrong with him. Y'all know something wrong with that nigga. Y'all know he need to talk to people better, and y'all enable his dumb ass. Like, that's y'all problem. Y'all be letting him, oh, he just not used to stuff like this. He's not used to being nice. He's not used to being a f-ing human. The common decency, he don't have common sense. And then when slow shit happen, y'all be like, oh, that's just Eli. Is he special needs? Is he? Because if he's special needs, I will leave him alone. I will leave the special needs alone. I will. Like, I will stop bothering him if he's special needs, because that is wrong. I do not condone bullying. I do not condone it. I don't condone bullying. But if he's special needs, if he's not special needs, he needs to get checked for it. He do. Because it be common ass things. How can you not understand common disrespect? Now I'm being disrespectful. Now I'm very disrespectful. I'm blatantly disrespectful. Blatantly. And I don't care. Who gonna be my ass? Cool. But yeah, I said what I said. I don't even care to be in a friend no more. I don't care. I don't care. Like, he shouldn't have never went on live first. Now we all on live. Up top. Now we all on live. We all bestie buddies. All that. You doing too much? No, I'm not doing enough. Because out of all the times that keep going live and saying something, and this is the first time I'm really getting in his bro.
Anyways, on the next clip, Ida came back on live, and this one explained better on what's going on, as you guys are going to be seeing. Now, on my side, I feel like Ella is playing games, okay? He being stubborn, that's all I can say. Some comments were saying he's manipulative. That one, I leave it for you guys to judge according to Ida's storyline. Okay, but yeah, it's crazy because on the internet seems like, you know, Ella is a sweetheart and, you know, he really gives an F about Ida, but according to the story, looks like he don't give an F. Okay, that's what it's giving. Yeah, enjoy, and let me catch you at the end of it.
I have a clear understanding, and I don't want y'all thinking I'm mad about some bags. Since he already came on here and said what he said and painted his image, I just want y'all to understand how I was feeling and how I feel right now currently, and why I got to a certain point of why I was angry. Cool. So last night, I surprised Eli. But before surprising him, for the past couple weeks, whatever days, I've been going through chaos, hell, trying to make things okay for his day. My hair appointment got canceled, moved back, pushed left, right, and up and down. The Nike Tech my mom bought him didn't show up. It was stolen and or given at the wrong place. Every time we went shopping for a Nike Tech, it didn't have his size or it wasn't, you know, up to par what we know he would like. Everything just wasn't working out on the day of. And I gave Chris and Debo one task, keep him away from the house all day. And unfortunately, for some reason, he made that very hard for them to keep him away from the house. Very, very hard. To the point that he actually ended up leaving. He left another person's car. He left in the middle, like, standing in the middle of the road, got an Uber back to the house, even though we asked him to stay away from the house. So he gets to the house. We hide all the gifts. I was about to say, F it, and just let him ruin the surprise because he wanted to. He was going around all the day, like, trying to figure out where Red was, and Red was helping me. He was already trying to ruin everything, basically. I'm not going to lie. So he gets to the house, and then I asked him, I was like, hey, can you do your hair upstairs? He didn't want to do his hair upstairs. So guess what? The people knock at the door to decorate the living room. He opens the door. And then he comes in the room. He's like, hey, some balloon people are here. What type of YouTube video are you trying to do? Like, da-da-da, asking OD questions, knowing damn well, I was trying to surprise you type shit. So I couldn't say that. So I was just like, dude, can you go upstairs and get your hair done? And he was just like, finally, reluctantly, he went upstairs to get his hair done. So he didn't see when they set up, but he see the balloons. He seen all that. So cool. So I'm trying to make the best of it, right? Mind you, he's getting his hair done. We even texted the hairstylist hours beforehand trying to, you know, all this extra stuff. Basically, he just made it difficult for everyone to try and surprise him. I was trying to surprise him. He made the whole entire task difficult, and it just seemed like he didn't want to be surprised. So I no longer will do that.
Right on, roll down the window.
Oh, it's hot. Hold on, Ma. Don't get in camera. Ooh, this is cute.
Roll down the window so he ain't hot.
Okay. Where the kid?
Roll them on.
Yes, ma'am. Okay, so cool. Oh, my little Yorkie baby. Hi. You wanna read it? Hi, honey. Hi. Oh, you so hard as you are. Come on, let's roll down the window. I wanna make sure you get air, babes. Oh no. Why is it locked? I can't roll down the window. You're so cute. Yes, you. Come on, you distracted me. Stop. You distracted me. Okay. So, back to what I was saying. So, he was making it very difficult to surprise him. So, mind you, I'm trying to force everyone to get over here. I'm like, hey, like, can y'all make sure he stays in his room? He was about to leave his room. Like, it was to the point they were even defeated. They didn't even want to try and keep him staying anymore. Like, it was so bad, but we made the best of it. So, like I said, just keep on to all the frustrations. So, mind you, I'm going to say this too. When they get there and they're getting him in the room, he was about to come downstairs again. Mind you, they're still trying to prep. So, we're trying to get him. They're like, Ida, you go upstairs. Maybe he's waiting for you or da-da-da. So, I go upstairs and it's just me and him and it's Nia. Nia ends up coming in the room. He's just like, you tried to surprise and surprise her. See, no, it don't work like that. So, you knew I was trying to surprise you all day. all day he knew it. And he was just like, you got the wrong people to keep track of me. Keep you away from the house all day. And you came back on purpose earlier than you should have. And then you opened the door. So, like, it was like, so even Nia was just like, why would you say that? So I left the room because, like, what? Like, why would you say, cool. So I left the room. Whatever the case may be, we end up surprising him. He doesn't have the actual surprise because, like, you know, he wasn't super surprised, but it's okay. It's cool. Move on. Fast forward. Today's the whole day. Actually, no. Get to, like, it's, like, 2 in the morning. We're still talking about the surprise. We're explaining everything we went through because, I'm not gonna lie, Eli was giving us hell. He was talking to me crazy. He was saying that I was lazy. I wasn't doing nothing I didn't have. I wasn't doing what I was supposed to do because I wasn't going OD on the videos, or I wasn't OD active on his Twitch, or XYZ. He was just getting on me, and he was like, I feel like you're being weird, and da-da-da. Whole entire time, for weeks, I'm trying to, like, plan something for you. I've been trying since, like, damn near before Miami. The whole reason we're going on the cruise is because I brought it up to Janae and Calvin. This whole entire thing is because of you. Like, I wanted you to actually enjoy your birthday genuinely without it, you know? And you ruined it. Cool. So then, when we're talking about everything, it's like 2 a.m. Cool. He's not genuinely surprised. Cool. Case may be. We about to go to sleep. Mind you, I'm tired as hell. I've literally been up since I don't know when, planning everything, making sure everything goes right. Like, and shout out to Fendi, shout out to Red, shout out to everyone who made it easier, even though Red is pissing me off by being a yes man right now, no shade, but they made the day easier because I've been stressed for weeks. I spent so much money, and it's not even about the money, but I genuinely cared about you having a good day, and you knew that people were trying to surprise you, and you ruined the surprise on purpose because you couldn't. I don't know what was wrong, but cool. So I'm tired. I want to take a nap. I guess he wanted to stay up. So around like 6 a.m., I realized that he wasn't in the bed. I was like, yo, like, where are you? You good? He ain't text me. He ain't saying nothing. I was like, all right, cool. I take another 30-minute nap. I start getting ready, packing. But this morning, I really had to I had to poop so freaking bad, my stomach was hurting. So this morning, I wake up, and I take a boogie or whatever, right? And as soon as I'm done, I come out the room, and I see that he's in the room. Like, his stuff was packed and everything. I see that he's in the room. So I'm like, hey, good morning. Because, you know, like, we're about to go to Miami. We're about to be on a cruise. So I said, good morning. Like, are you okay? Like, is there a reason why you didn't sleep in the bed? No response. Yo, you good? No response. Yet, he walks out like a bad bitch. Like, I wasn't just talking to him. Oh. Okay. Cool, so it threw me off. I'm like, yo, like, what happened to the point where it's like you gotta ignore me blatantly? Mind you, I don't like being ignored blatantly because he doesn't like when he be talking to me and I don't pay him no mind. Mind you, sometimes I be engrossed in my phone. He didn't have no phone, he didn't have nothing. So it's just like, you're blatantly ignoring me. Okay, cool. So now I'm rushing to pack. Mind you, my packing only takes like 10 minutes because, like, I had everything already, like, sitting out, already ready for me to pack. This dude literally says, all right, I'm gonna see you at the airport. You're not gonna wait for me? That's literally first thing. You're not gonna wait for me? Oh, nah, I gotta check in. I didn't check in through the app. So, yeah, I'm gonna see you. Oh, what? Oh, you can't. Okay, cool. What the hell? So I was like, yo, like, what's going? Like, last night was good. Like, now today is a problem. I'm like, yo, what the fuck just happened? Cool. So, again, I'm packing my stuff. I'm trying to rush now because, like, I at least want to make it to go with you. But then it's just like, okay, cool. I had 2 suitcases in a little bag. Cool. I pushed my suitcases and stuff. I finished dressing. Mind you, I still had my blanket in the room and stuff like that. So, the night before, I asked Red, and they watched them make this just about that. This is the important part. I asked Red to roll up a blunt so we can have something to hit before we go on the plane, because I always go to the plane, like, either hot so I can go to sleep, you know, because, like, sleeping on a plane is uncomfortable sometimes. So I was like, okay, cool, let me make sure me and Red is good. I literally, cool. So I said, make sure you roll one so when we, you know, cool. So, boom. I go downstairs and I'm trying to bring down my bag. I'm like, Red, where's the blunt at? And he's just like, oh, I placed it up in the room. Mind you, Eli's walking downstairs already. He has his bag. He's walking outside or something. I'm like, okay, bet. Let me go back up to the room. I go to the room. The door's locked. Why is the door locked? I was like, can you go ask Eli for your key? He was like, oh, like, you better catch him before, like, you know, he trying to leave. Yo, can I see your key? Mind you, now at this point, him and Red are both outside. Oh, hi, baby. Him and Red are both outside. So I'm like, hey, can I get your key real quick? He's just looking at me. He's sitting on his suitcase and he's looking at me. I'm like, I need to get something out the room. Just looking at me. Okay, cool. What the fuck? So I was like, you know what? I'm cool. I just went back inside. I grabbed my suitcases. Mind you, he doesn't always get my suitcase. But just because you don't always do it doesn't mean it needs to be normalized. I am still a female at the end of the day. You are Red. Normally, like, at least Red normally offer to carry my suitcase down or help. If you know you're trying to leave, why would you leave me in the house with two suitcases trying to bring it down? Thing I told Calvin, I was like, hey Calvin, tell him do not go on Twitch and bring up my name and talk about if we're cool or not, or, like, you know, I don't want him to say nothing. We just landed like 10-15 minutes ago or whatever. We got our bags and I'm leaving to go be with my mom. The next thing you know, we get a live notification. He's on Twitch and he's talking about some, so guys, wait, we gotta wait till everyone gets in here so we can talk about this, because this is real, like, this is crazy. It's some crazy stuff. If you are going to use the situation as a storyline for Twitch, we could have created a storyline together like coworkers. We could have did that together. If you want to get your money back for paying on the cruise, you could have told me that. Like, that's like, you doing this on Twitch is just like, how many times do I have to tell you not to go on the internet? And you go on the internet each time. You prove to me that you're internet. Each time you prove to me that you're internet. Used to this. He's working. He's da da da. Okay, but when a person will get on live and know an angle to go at their supporters, like, okay, boom. If I tell my supporters that she's mad at me again, and they can ask me a whole bit, like, why is she mad? Da da da. And I can just tell them first, like, she just got mad at me out of nowhere. They're gonna be on my side, and then they're not gonna care. Cause I don't do the internet shit. I hate having to explain it to y'all, because it makes everyone look crazy if we're cool again. Like, why bring shit to the internet if you know you probably might want to be around me eventually? Like, that's weird. Like, everything could have been talked about. That's what I'm saying. He's childish. Like, that's what I'm saying. I don't like the child shit. I don't like that. And, like, you acting like particular activities because I'm not that active as I used to. But I do it for you. If I know that he would hate if I went to the internet, I wouldn't go on the internet. But I told him. So, and I told him even before this even happened on the, you know, I literally said it to Calvin because I wanted Calvin to say it nicer than me. Because I know when I'm upset, my mouth can be foul. So that's why I'm redoing it, because my mouth was just foul like half an hour ago. It was foul as fuck. But my whole understanding is, don't sit here and say you're changing and this, that, and third. Oh, I'm working on it, this, that, and third, just to be an asshole for no reason after I just surprised you that you ruined the surprise because you couldn't be surprised. And then be confused when I get angry. And then paint an image on the freaking internet like I'm crazy and that I'm always has the attitudes. No, I'm really chill. I'm a really chill person, I promise you. It takes a lot for me to, like, get out of my character. When, back in the day, it used to take a little bit to get me out of my character, but it takes a lot. So the fact that you keep poking and prodding and you keep trying to, like, depaint my image, because it's already easier to paint me as an aggressor because I can't. I'm a dominant woman, I will say that. But as a dominant woman, I do know what I do and don't deserve. You had no right to talk to me like that this morning. You had no right to ignore me out of nowhere. Like, none of that I will let you get a green light for, especially if I just tried to make sure you genuinely had a good birthday. And then you go sit. Now, and to prove my point even more, he tries to... You ruined your own surprise. You did. And then again, you ruined this trip because you wanted to be weird towards me, then text my friends and say, I don't know, she's been weird since this morning. Like, damn. Girl, I wouldn't went home. I spent over like $3,000 to $4,000. I'm not going home. I'm not going home. I can't. Like, I prioritized his surprise over getting my hair done. And y'all know how much I love getting my hair done. I'm not gonna cry. My nose is stuff. Y'all just gotta get off the internet. Bro, here's the thing though. I work on the internet. I'm fine working on the internet. I'm cool. When's the last time y'all ever really see me come to the internet about drama or beef? I don't do that shit. Either I fight you when I see you, or it's just that. Back then, I used to be Captain Save-A-Ho. That was back then. I said I grew as a person. I hate coming on the internet and explaining myself. I hate that because it's not y'all problem. I never want to put that on y'all. I never want y'all to be like, oh my God, well, we got to get them back cool. No. As real, like, we're adults. Like, we're 21 going on 25. We need to learn how to be adults and talk to each other. If we was going to talk to each other, it would have happened in person. You went straight to the internet like I was about to come at you sideways. If you know me as a person, I don't air out nobody's business on the internet. None. I fell out with a bunch of people, and I never did it. Never. You won't see me doing that. You know why? Because what's the point? So that's why it's just like, I'm sorry that I gotta explain it to y'all, but I had to tell y'all because he already went on goddamn Twitch. And I don't want y'all talking about some, I need to stop being mad about petty stuff. It's more than about the suitcase. It's the principle. I tried so hard last night. You ruined that. Then this morning you had an attitude with me like I did something to you. And then you go on your excuses. You're not a morning person. Is exactly. I don't allow disrespect. Just as he wants to go on a trip together, no one's gonna sit in my face blatantly ignoring me. Huh. No one's gonna not carry my bags once in a while. Huh. Oh hell nah. No.
Well, that marked the end of the video. Hope you guys enjoyed it, and if you did, make sure you leave me a thumbs up and, you know, leave your thoughts down below. Let me know what you guys think. Plus, don't forget, please, to share my video. Let me catch you next time, my next ones. Bye.